guys, last time we saw you, we had a pile of lumber over here, and we're getting ready to build one of these guys, a big old continuous flow worm bin that can hold as much as 1 million worms. Today, I'm going to take you over and show you only the frame. The frame is this section down below, and we have built that, and we're going to take you right over to that section, and we're going to go step by step. So this basically is the base. It's 8 foot long. It's 30 inches wide. It's made out of treated lumber, strong as an ox. We put these little pieces on because when I go to put the sides on, that's what will hold them. Hold the sides as I'm adjusting it to get the sides on. This is it. This is basically the frame. Our next step will be we'll put the continuous flow pipes in so that you can take a rake underneath here and rake out all the compost and the pressure of the ton and a half of compost or bedding in there continue to fall down and you just rake it out. I pulled out 5 tons last year out of one of these bins. So that's basically it. That's the frame. We'll see you again as soon as I get the pipes on. And again, thank you for coming to view this. Hopefully, as we're progressing through this, you're gonna see the simplicity of it, and you also will be able to build one. Hey folks, Captain Matt here again. We are building a worm bin, and I just wanted to take you through the next step. The earlier part of this video, we built the frame. For your information, every screw that I put in the frame gets pre-drilled first on angles. And I use a 2.5 inch screw for the frame. And then when we use the pipes, I use a two inch screw for the pipes. But the frame is as sturdy as can be. I mean, you can't rock that baby. So here's what we did today. I put all the piping on the top. I started out with 10 foot, 3/4 inch PVC pipe. I went to my chop saw and chopped them into just short of 30 inch. The width of the bin is 30 inches. So these are just short of 30 because you don't want them touching the side. When we put the plywood on the side, we want it to be able to pull right in. So I drilled, I cut these into 30, 29 and a half or so inches. And it's a tedious process. You have to drill each hole and then put a screw in, come over here, drill the hole and try to keep them lined up so they don't run off to the left or off to the right by the time you get to the end. Here we are. So this is what the inside of my worm bins look like. They have this area and I've set it up so that a rake can get your rake and take our rake and we'll go underneath with the rake and we just start. So we put the rake in and we can start pulling it through. Next thing that we'll do, and I'll hopefully get it done tomorrow, is I'll put up the sides and then we'll meet. I'll bring Mark back again and we'll photo the sides and show you a few pointers on that. But we're gonna have worms in a worm bin real, real soon. Okay guys, good seeing you. Talk to you again real soon, as soon as I get the sides up.